Good afternoon, everyone. It's actually rather strange to say that. Normally I say good evening, because if you didn't know already, since the 23rd of April, I have been doing live stream concerts on my channel on YouTube every night at 8 Central. However, today I wanted to do a full-length recital because I haven't played live for my mother or my grandmother going on a decade, I think. I know it's 13 years for my grandmother, and it's coming up on that for my mom. And I'm really excited because both my mom and my grandma actually get to see this today. And that's really exciting. Mother's Day is a day, I think, when we miss a lot of people normally. I mean, either people who can't be with us physically or really can't be with us physically. And so we're sort of all in the same boat today, I think. So how about you? I mean, where are you celebrating today? It makes me so happy that I can do this, that I can do these live concerts, even though we are in the midst of something which is pretty unprecedented. But it's pretty marvelous that we can be all in this together. And that makes me really happy. Just to let you know, you already know, but my name is Trevor Patrick Watkin, and I am based in Chicago. And today I am broadcasting from Access Contemporary Music, which is the school where I teach. I'm the director of operations here, but I've also been teaching here for about 6.5 years. This is my creative home. This is a place where I feel really, well, at home, truly. And that's why I wanted to share this place with you. Access Contemporary Music was founded in 2004 by Seth Bosted, who was the longtime host of Relevant Tones on WFMT. However, now it is a live stream, and you should definitely check it out. Access Contemporary Music is not just a music school, but we also have events like Sound of Silent Film. We are partnered with Open House, and it's events all over the place. Events in Barcelona, events in Milwaukee, events in Mexico City, New York City. It's just a really marvelous organization to be a part of. And that's why I wanted to share this with you. Because this is a place right now where I feel connected. I live really close to here, and I had really tried to sort of do things. I am teaching remotely, of course. In fact, I did that today. And I was trying to do things from home, but it wasn't doing it for me. And so I make the short trek down here every day to do my work here, because it enables me to feel like I'm connected to the world around me and able to get things done. And these live streams are a part of that. So I genuinely hope that you will join me on my YouTube channel. Now, I had meant to do, I'm going to come clean. I had meant to do my normal live stream tonight at 8. However, this is the first time I've ever tried to produce a recital. And I'm not offering an excuse. I'm just letting you know. I'm leveling with you. This is the first time that I've ever tried to produce a full-length recital virtually in this way through OBS. And I discovered that there wasn't any way to be able to prepare properly for this recital and for tonight's live stream. And I'm not going to do a show that I'm not prepared for. So I've rescheduled that. I'm going to do what I had planned to do tonight, I'm going to do tomorrow night. And then I'm going to upload this live stream up onto YouTube instead this evening. But I'm glad you're here. And so I want to talk a little bit about tonight. I want to talk a little bit about the program. First of all, I want to offer you an apology. I am clearly not attired the way one would expect when attending a recital. Ordinarily, I'd be wearing my button down, I'd be wearing a tie, I'd be wearing slacks, I'd be wearing a coat. However, since the start, I discovered quite to my, I can't say I was terribly surprised. I was very disappointed to find out, though. I no longer fit into any of my performance clothes, because since the start of quarantine, you fill in the blanks. I needed to have a come to Jesus with myself, and I need to make better choices with regard to what I'm eating. So today I am wearing things that are more stretchy. I am wearing my concert black. That I will say that. I'm wearing my concert black for you, but I apologize for not being attired the way one would expect at a formal recital, but I'm so glad you're here. Another thing too, just to level with you in another way, this is still, even though I've been at this for a little over 2 weeks, doing these live recitals is definitely a sort of learning curve for me as far as working with OBS, which is the system that I use. And because I'm playing live against a recorded backing track, there is a delay, and OBS has a way of compensating for it. But oh my goodness, every time I log into the program, it just seems like, I don't know, there's no way to prepare. It's completely unpredictable. And I beg your forgiveness. I am very much hoping that today is in sync for you. I have done my darndest to make sure that it is. In fact, I had every single one of my pieces in their own separate tracks. I had all this stuff beautifully laid out, and it just wasn't working. So when I start tonight's recital, this afternoon's recital, it's one long track because that was the only way that I could make it work. So ordinarily I like to do little spiels about the different pieces that I'm playing, but tonight, I don't know, maybe this is a blessing because I do tend to go on quite a while. Tonight, once I start playing, that's the recital, and you can just lay back and enjoy it, I hope. These are pieces that I have been doing on my live streams, and I enjoy them very much, and this is why I'm sharing these with you tonight. This afternoon. I keep saying tonight. Oh my gosh. But anyway, happy Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Happy Mother's Day, Gaga. And I hope you're out there. If you're out there, please say hello because it'd be wonderful to see you there in the audience. So here we are. The program is listed in the events. Like I said, once I start this thing, I mean, I've got everything from Jethro Tull to Bach to tango to all sorts of stuff. So I'm really looking forward to playing for you, and I think it's time I get started. So here we are. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That may be the longest I've gone without talking in the last 3 weeks, I think. as I say, normally I'm used to being able to sort of chat with everybody and sort of talk about the pieces. I'm going to say it every day. I'm praying all of that was in sync. You have no idea. Oh my gosh. So I'm praying. Well, anyway, you know what? Sorry. All that matters is that you enjoyed yourself. Today, Mother's Day, like Christmas, like so many wonderful holidays, are days that are filled with pain as well as filled with love. Sometimes both at the same time. There are perhaps mothers who don't have their children with them anymore and children who don't have their mothers with them anymore. I'm very lucky because my mother is watching from Colorado. Some people have mothers who are watching from heaven. We don't know. In fact, this has been a very interesting experience. One of my very good friends lost his mother very, very recently. And one of my wonderful friends just gave birth to her second child. So in reality, this recital is for Frankie and it's for Janice too. It's for my mother. It's for my grandmother. It's for all of you and all of your mothers and all of, I'm very lucky to come from a very long line of women who don't take any crap. What can I say? In fact, well, I'll just go ahead and say it. I have been Trevor Patrick Watkin, but I had a conversation the other day with a friend of mine who is she's pregnant with her next child, and we were talking about names and gender appropriate names. And I'm not going to start a discussion because there really isn't a discussion, because my middle name is in honor of my grandmother, whose name is Patricia. And I was talking with her and I was like, it doesn't make any sense for my middle name to be Patrick. If I'm named for Patricia, why shouldn't I be Patricia? But I didn't want to do anything rash. I needed to talk to my mother, because I needed to make sure. I asked her, I was like, would it make you sad if I changed my name? Because I didn't know. I wasn't sure if there was some kind of, if it was just Patricia to Patrick, if there was anything else, I needed to know. So I'm changing my name. So right now I am still legally Trevor Patrick, but I'm going to be Trevor Patricia. And I think that's really cool. I am really excited because I'm named after my middle name is after my grandmother, Patricia. My first name is because I know my mother always wanted to have a son named Trevor. I was supposed to be Courtney. If I was a girl, I was going to be Courtney. But it's exciting. I'm really looking forward to it. And it's really kind of cool. And also a little bit walking the walk, putting my money where my mouth is. It's just been a thrill to have you here. Thank you so much for being here with me. I haven't done a full-length recital in a really long time, and I'm really grateful that I have this medium. I could cry. I am so glad that this recital was in sync for you. I'm just so glad. I'll stop short of there. So I want to do this more often. And speaking of more often, every night at 8 p.m. Central Time, I am on my YouTube channel, doing a nightly concert, not nearly this long. We're roughly 20 minutes, ish. They get longer because I have a lot to say, apparently. As I mentioned earlier, I did think that I would be able to do this recital and then do my live stream, but when it came down to it, it was more important that I prepared well for this and made sure that the audio was synced. And so the concert that I had, the concert that I had planned for tonight, well, concert, the live stream, little morsel, whatever, that has been moved to tomorrow. So come and find me. I'm not going to lie, I'm a little bit happy that I'm done for the day. So it's just been a thrill to share this with you, and I hope you'll come find me later. Happy Mother's Day. And to those of you that are hurting, I hope that this has helped in some way, because this is the best I can give. And I thank you so much for sharing this day with me, sharing this time with me. To my mother, Terry, I love you. To my grandmother, Patricia, I love you. And I'm so glad that you were able to join me today. I can't even tell you. So many more to come. Admittedly, this is the new normal, but I'm happy to adapt and I'm happy to play as much as I possibly can. And I'm so grateful that I have this medium in order to do so. So happy Mother's Day. And I hope you have a wonderful week ahead. Stay happy and stay healthy. And I hope to see you soon.